this is Solar PVTV once again from REST for Africa event here in Addis Abeba, Ethiopia. And now we are together with one of the pioneers in solar industry. Yes.
Yes.
My friend since maybe 15 years, Jalel Amil. And Jalel is director for Middle East and Africa for Day Solar, one of the top module manufacturers in the world. So Jalel, what brings you here to Ethiopia?
So what brings me here, Ethiopia, is really, we see it as a great potential market for solar. You've seen that right now they have a pipeline that announced about 500-600 megawatt in PV specifically. Also, they have wind and geothermal. With the 100 megawatt that they will, the outcome of the auction will come out this week, I think, and then followed by two phases. So this is the utility scale. We also see a large distributed generation market. This is 100 million plus population with very low rate.
Second largest population in Africa.
Yes, in Africa, and very low electrification rate. That means down the road, we're talking about growth in energy demand that is going to skyrocket with the high, basically, development of the level of 10%.
Economic growth.
Economic growth, yes. So these are basically very important vectors to make it an attractive market. Obviously, there are still some challenges in the policies, in the implementations, in the financing, in the currencies, as an, on a global or a high level, but from practical level, I think solar will have a big place in the energy mix.
So because also we saw today that there is a big involvement of the government. Yes, there was Minister of Environment, there was Minister, Deputy Minister of Finance, there was State Minister of Industry. So let's say that high level politicians came to the event, but also they commit, yes?
Correct. Actually, you highlighted a very, very important point, because if I compare to other markets that were at the similar stages, it was very, very difficult to get high-level people, ministers, in such events. And plus, real involvement and commitment. So we see it as a positive point. And as I said, there are other steps that need to happen on the ground, but we're very satisfied to see that things are really, I would say, moving forward. They might be slow, but again, this market is...
Step by step.
Yes, exactly.
And when we discussed today with Minister of Environment, with State Minister for Industry, so they really underlined the fact that they do not count just on help, yes, on aid, but they really count on contribution, yes, so that the actors who are coming to the country, they also contribute, yes, to grow the economy. So how do you see that from the perspective of the Chinese company? It's, are you just, you know, willing to sell your products here, or you also provide some, you know, you would like to contribute to the market?
Okay, that's a very good question. So I think, again, the market will go through different stages or different steps. And I think the initial step has to be understood that probably the participation will be through providing reliable, low-cost, economical viable solutions, such as PV modules for our case and other components. Also assistance in financing, because that's the most challenging things. And down the road, you have to build, I would say, an environment with local entrepreneurs, local investors that will be jointly by the international investors or Chinese manufacturer or Chinese funds to work together through these steps. So the government by...
So basically like partnership step
exactly,
by step.
Exactly, yes, yes. So I don't think this can be answered in one, I would say, in one step or in a direct way. It has to go through different stages, different approaches that has to be aligned between the international solar companies. Part of them are the Chinese manufacturer and investors, with the other, with the European and Americans and international investors, together to put hands and lay out the strategies you have probably to develop research, development, to create knowledge and transfer of know-how, upstream, downstream, depends where the the solution can apply and be competitive, and then help on the small scale, especially the distributed generation down the road. That will be more longer term. At the beginning, they will start with the utility scale, obviously, because that's the easiest to start with. And then, yeah, and then with the help of some of the DFIs and World Bank, the NGOs, and some of the other participant in these emerging markets, then eventually we'll create the environment to boost basically the solar. So,
and before last question, so you are working for JA Solar, and JA Solar, I think this year was quite successful. Yes, for the company on a global level in China. And how was the situation for JA Solar in your region?
So, in a global level, JA Solar will finish this year roughly with a capacity of 7 gigawatt cell and module PV module assembly production, and with probably business that's closer to those numbers by the end of the year. And still most of it, due to the high demand in the Chinese market, more than half goes to China, and especially the high efficiency, what we call the first runner project, where demand on the highest level of efficiency from module, since we run those modules. From the rest of the markets, Middle East and Africa market is starting to show some positive signs. We have projects in Jordan, Turkey, the distributed solar farms in Dubai started. South Africa, it's on the verge of signing the next phase for the implementation, and fewer projects are being basically finalized, financed in sub-Saharan Africa that we might get involved with through the developers and the EPCs that will win those projects. North Africa, through some of the projects that are going from Morocco to Algeria to Tunisia. But these also, some of them are taking time, but down the road we see it as a growth market.
So you are changing from explorer to implementer?
Yes, right now we see more implementation. I don't know, in Egypt, for example, JA Solar already, from some of the project implemented, has a presence with the modules in Mauritania, in other market. We already have project implemented and running. So we see it as a first step to a larger growth coming down the road.
And last question, because you have this sexy here. Rest for Africa. Are you a member of Rest for Africa?
We're not.
Do you think? Because Roberto asked me to recruit some members.
Sure, yeah. Why not? We will discuss it. But Roberto also, we had a short discussion. So we'll probably assist at the first stage, and we'll see how we can make sure it's successful.
How do you know? Because you are attending a lot of events, and how do you see this particular event here, about REST for Africa? Was it successful from your point of view, if you compare, because we are meeting, like every month in other countries?
So this is my first time in Addis Ababa and in Ethiopia. I've been to different events for the last 6 years or more in different countries with the similar situation. And I think this one is really successful. And I think one of the important things is also the RS for Africa team and NL were able to bring really a good participation, high-level participation and commitment, which will make it really, and the learning also lessons from previous conferences with other players and other countries. So this is basically showing a trend in the success in approaching a new market, and I think it's very positive.
Okay. So thank you so much. That was Solar PVTV together with Jalal Hamel. Hamila, who is director for Middle East and Africa for JA Solar, and who probably maybe will become also a member of REST for Africa, but for sure he liked so much the event here. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.